So, we begin by answering the question, what is the Center for Open and Distance Learning? The Center for Open and Distance Learning is an academic center for managing processes related to open and distance learning. It is one of the operational structures of the College of Education and External Studies at Kikuyu Campus. The founding director of the Center for Open and Distance Learning is Chekonia Odumbe. The center has 5 units to enable it to fulfill its mandate. These units include Print Materials Development Unit, Audio and Visual Material Development Unit, E-Learning Unit and Evaluation, Research and Quality Control Unit, whose personnel have yet to be hired, and Learner Support and a Program Coordination Unit. What are the functions of the Center for Open and Distance Learning? The main function of the center is to facilitate processes of diversifying learning by distance mode at the University of Nairobi. The center brings together the various colleges and the schools of the University of Nairobi to make decisions on who and how to proceed with writing. The Center for Open and Distance Learning begins its activities of material development by sensitizing stakeholders in 6 colleges of the University of Nairobi and on the benefits of distance learning and the policy directions. The process of material development in open and distance learning starts with first identifying courses for writing, identifying writers in the faculties and the departments, budgeting for writing, review, editing, production, and distribution of finished products. Since there is already a syllabus for courses taught at the university, there is usually no problem at this stage. Whether we start with this or that department, it's a matter of who shows interest first. But often, The Center for Open and Distance Learning moves around colleges, schools and departments, providing rationale for open and distance learning. After identification of courses, faculties or departments identify writers to write specific course contents. It is at the planning stage that the delivery technology are identified and appropriate learner and tutor support mechanisms are set up. This includes identification of regional centers, the types of offline and online materials to further support student learning. The stage that follows planning is training writers and writing itself.
Then for the old writers, these are people basically who have been here before, and they are coming mainly from the College of Biological and Physical Sciences. They are developing the climate change and analytical chemistry programs. And then for those who are here from College of Architecture and Engineering on energy management, you will be expected that this workshop will enable you to share input on the characteristics of cool self-reflection materials.
My expectation is that by the end of this particular session, we'll be having as many as probably possible fully developed courses.
Since selected course writers have teaching duties in their departments, it is a normal practice in open and distance learning to take writers away from their workstations and homes so that they can devote all their efforts to writing. The university management provides financial and moral support to address logistical issues relating to arranging transport for writers, support staff, computers, stationery, liaising with the managers of writing venues so that the environment around the writing venue is conducive to writing. And of course, tokens for all participants as an incentive for writing or supporting the writing process is provided. Writing workshops provide an avenue for useful material design practice by way of discussion, critique, and suggestion from participants and workshop facilitators.
Even before you bring in human beings.
Okay.
Yeah.
Location of the industrial area, because Nairobi produces it and it comes to where your people are living.
Okay.
But industrial activity is very, very central, because essentially what creates, okay?
The dumping sites, industrial activities,
because not just the number of people, you produce very little
from.
It is during the actual writing that several activities in the form of debates are generated.
I feel they will require a lot more in instructor-student interaction in explaining some of these concepts, and especially the practical side of carrying out the experiment. If it was a fourth-year course, I would just unleash them and kill yourselves if you want. After all, you've been alive 4 years. If you kill yourself now, it's up to you.
Okay.
But at this, I don't know how. It's a self-instructing manual.
Yes.
But I feel it still needs a lot of instructor presence and experience.
The plenary session provide new avenue for quality in the final product, and they are part of peer review. Plenary sessions and the review by appointed content person also ensures parity of standards and esteem in the course materials. These activities are a form of instruction design support. The academic staff providing instruction design support include the director of the Center for Open and Distance Learning and selected facilitators. The computer is the main tool used in writing and organizing content. During this time, technical support and troubleshooting is provided by a team of computer experts from the University of Nairobi. For academic staff who may not have the confidence of using the computer, a secretariat composed by the Center for Open and Distance Learning is often ready to type and save the work in university computers. Course materials that have been written and reviewed are printed and bound at the printing unit at Kikuyu campus, ready for distribution as printed modules. Writers receive another training in e-learning in line with the University of Nairobi mission and also to join other higher education institutions in embracing e-learning as an innovative way in teaching and learning.
So once you are there, you have to have rights to log in. For the student is the registration number, for the staff we normally use the payroll number, and then the password you can put your own. But the default password we give a default password and then later on the users can change.
The University of Nairobi e-learning portal has a course management system with rich course design tools able to administer assignments, tests, synchronous chat and asynchronous discussion forum, among others. The e-learning personnel from the university are responsible for training academic members of staff.
We are there. So can we create a new question now?
Materials in audio and video may be partly done at Kikuyu or done in collaboration with institutions or providers with recording and packaging and the duplicating facilities.